What are you doing, butthole? I'm already an hour late for the comedy show. Dang, I'm never going to make it. Rush hour traffic was 2 hours, and I'm still late. Darn it. Hello? Yeah, baby, I told you I'm on my way to the comedy show. I got to see this new act. I heard he's really good. What? Where'd you hear that? He hasn't... Baby, he's never done a show before. Yes, I left my glasses at home. No! They're broken? Now I gotta get more? I told you I have front row seats. I don't need my glasses. And if they're broken, what does it matter? Look, I'm gonna have to call you back. All right.
Oh, ladies and gentlemen, I'm gonna need you to give it up. It's just his first time, so be easy on him. We don't need the Apollo out here. We don't need Apollo.
Oh, thank goodness, right on time. I made it. Yeah, let me just get a
my friend, the one and only, the new kid on the block, Gerald Cunningham.
Woohoo!
Come on, welcome him, people. Yeah. Come on, come on. Show some love. Show some love.
Hey, how you doing?
Yeah.
Everybody's doing all right? I see you're not waving, man.
Yeah, he's probably having a bad night.
Probably not worse than mine, huh? Hey, this is my first time, and you guys gotta bear with me. I'm a little bit nervous, but you know, this is a nice city. Nice city you guys got here, huh? Yeah, I almost smell what the rock is cooking. The air's bad. Bad. It's almost like everybody here farted. Anyway, look. I got one for you. Hey, check this out. What did the fish say when he swam into the wall?
Damn.
Yeah.
Man, this guy sucks.
Am I right? Am I wrong? Okay. Hey, listen. We call an American comes out of the bathroom. European, right? Am I right? Yeah? Oh, yes. I know. Hey, you know, hold your tomatoes, you know. I like sandwiches, but I don't like the tomatoes. Hold for the sandwich. Oh, okay. How about this? Hey, listen. You know, you clean your house. Houses get dirty, you know, what can you do? But I had to get rid of my vacuum. You want to know why? You know why? No, that's not why.
Collecting dust.
I had to get rid of my vacuum because all it was doing was collecting dust.
Get him out of here.
Oh, God. I'm a little nervous. Let me get a drink of water. Hey, listen. Everybody loves cars. You love cars? How about this? You know... You got a car, you just bought it. You know, you gotta get your money. But why doesn't a black car wanna go drive through the hood? Anybody?
Afraid to get jumped.
Because he's afraid to get jumped.
Yeah.
No? But anyway. Thanks everybody a lot, and we just did this raffle, and we want to see who won. The winner of this raffle gets to spend the day with me, the comedian Gerald Cunningham, and our winner is. Is there a Chad in the house?
Right here. I'm right here with the hand.
Come on up here.
Hey, what's up, man?
Well, you know, I wish I could do that, but my hand is pretty full.
No problem. I'm your number one fan.
Yeah.
I have been a fan since tonight. I see the potential.
Yeah.
I see the potential so much, man.
Yeah, that's great.
When you make it to the top, I'm going to be there in the stadium saying, hey, I was at his first show on, what's the date?
Well, if you don't know what time it is, but it's time for you to say hi to the fans and hi to everybody that's sitting up there watching this TV show.
Hi, everybody.
Yeah?
How you doing?
All right. right. Yeah, he's good. Okay. All right. Time's up, Chad. Time to go. And thanks for having me. You guys been great. I know, you know, you guys are having a bad night. It probably's not bad after the night, but hey, thank you a whole lot. I appreciate it. And I see you next week. All right. Get the hell out of here, Chad.
This is great, you know. Nice night. Not too much wind. Last time it almost blew my drink over.
Yeah, yeah. Hey, speaking of which, did you hear that ambulance that was running by just a second ago?
You know, I did. It's a funny joke. I mean, I know you're the king of them, but maybe one of your jokes killed somebody. Looks like it, huh?
Yeah, you know, well, you're probably right. But at least they died from laughter.
That's
what
I get it.
What's so funny?
Nothing.
That's a problem. Not funny enough, man. It's killing me.
I beg to differ. I believe you, man. I really think what you've been doing just hasn't caught on yet. It's like the artist Jay-Z. You know, he was rapping and they didn't get his flow at first. But as soon as other people caught on to it, he caught on. He caught on to the fact that people like this flow, so he just stuck with it, you know?
Yeah, well, it does seem like people are catching on fast enough.
Yeah.
I think I'm going to have to change up the routine.
What are you thinking? Drama?
Change up the routine.
Sounds good.
A lot of things are going to change after I change up the routine. You do understand that, right? I don't want you to get nervous. I don't want you to get all bent out of shape. And I don't want you to go crying off and go running off. Just stick with it, okay?
Like blue.
The only fan I got. That means a lot to me. Hey, cheer. The only fan I got, because see, if I lose you, then it's going to be bad for everybody. And that, my friend, will be no laughing.
And let me tell you something, buddy. Not to kill the mood. I know it's a Friday night. We're having fun. Drinks on the house and all that good stuff. But,
you got it.
This is the thing. The world. As bad enough as it is. It's already dramatic, you know?
Yeah.
People with, you know, depression, traumatic experiences, post-traumatic stress disorder. They need things like comedy to keep them alive. Without that, they would have been gone a long time ago.
And
that's where I come in. To support people like you, we're just trying to show the world that, you know?
Yeah, I appreciate that. I appreciate that. Well, if you wanna start appreciating something, you can start appreciating getting us another drink. All right, bartender, get us another drink.
Give me that, give me this, give me that, give me all of it. I want it all. I want 4 number ones, 6 number twos, 10 number tens, 11 a number 11s.
We're going to be the wave 3 for Halloween. We're already backed up.
Now let me see your manager. I want the whole menu. Yeah, I want lo mein. I want shrimp fly wok. I want flaming wok. I want all the General Tso's chicken. I want it all. I want it all. Give me fried rice. I need the biggest bowl of fried rice you got. I want the biggest cream. I want the big pizza. I want 15 larges, 20 smalls. Everything. Put it all on. Everything you got. Load me up. I want the pizza with the works.
I think I finally found my purpose. Gerald Cunningham is my only true friend, and I would do anything in my power to protect him, his career, and our friendship.
Where the heck is Gerald? He told me to meet him here for drinks. And he's an hour late, of course. But he's a great comedian. Where's he at?
Hey, Chad Stur, how you doing, man? Hey. Chad Dickerson, Chad Erica. What the hell is your last name anyway?
It
doesn't matter anyway. Here, look, toast to you, man. Thanks for coming out to have a drink with me, man. Yeah.
So, you like your first show?
Yeah, you know, I gotta be honest, it was a hard one. It was a rough one. But you stuck with me, man, and I wanna thank you for hanging in there, man.
Yes, sir.
Hey, you know, I ran into one of my fellow comedians last night while I was doing a show.
Pee Wee Herman?
No, not Pee Wee Herman. Guess again.
Bill Bellamy?
No, I saw him last week. Guess again.
Beats me.
One more try. I know you got it. Take one more guess. I'm pretty sure you got it. Think Batman.
Commissioner Gordon?
Yeah, but hey, on a lighter note, did you hear about it? Last night, after the show, they found some guy, some big fat guy, stabbed to death in the alley over there across from coming out of the food court.
No.
Yeah, man, it's just crazy.
Who would do something like that? That is sick.
Wait a minute. Ask that question again. Let me see if I got that right.
Who would do something like that?
The guy who killed him, that's who would do something like that. You know anything? You have any idea? Well, who would do something like that? Something so horrible. I mean, you gotta be out of your mind. I mean, you gotta be literally the most vicious, the most sadistic, the most horrendous, horrible person ever to walk up face of the planet of the earth to do something like that.
I tell you what, I am absolutely 100% positively offended in a negative way that something like this has happened after your show and they don't even want to see who did it.
Hey,
I tell you, man.
Hey, calm
it's
down.
It's so terrible.
Calm down.
You know, I mean, it's a laughing night and everybody's laughing, having a good time. It's no laughing matter. Nothing funny about it. No ands, ifs, ands, buts, or teeth, plus dots of the eyes.
So you do think it was murder?
Ain't no telling.
So you do think it was a horrible thing that happened?
I think it was absolutely horrible.
So you do think the Giants are winning right now?
I think the Buckeyes are playing, but if the Giants are winning, that's probably good, because I've never been to New York, but I've always wanted to go.
Even better.
You're from the East Coast, right?
Dude.
Philly.
Even better. I'm from Philadelphia.
Oh,
gosh.
Gotta go.
That's where a lot of guys go there.
One of my best friend bought me back.
What do you think his wife thought when she heard about the news that his body was found covered with pizza? I mean, I love pizza like the next Ninja Turtle, but I would never slice a guy up like sausages, green peppers, onions, bacon bits, and even the pepperoni that you
and
put on the pizza.
At the end of the day, I heard they found him in the oven with a smiley face made out of pepperonis and covered in his stomach.
Oh, gosh, even worse, you know. You know, you gotta watch it on those pizzas, man. Those pizzas that kill you.
Hey, man, I'm all out, man. These drinks at the bar are really good. You want another one?
I mean, so you do think it was, like the worst murder ever, man. You do think that was wrong.
Yeah.
I mean, definitely. You know, I mean, because I've seen it all, man. I've seen documentaries. I've seen Bantam TV. I've seen it all. And that's just something that you do not want to get involved with.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, you know,
oh,
so much blood, it'll make you even want to stop drinking Bloody Marys.
Oh, yeah.
And I love them myself, to be honest with you. And I'll tell you what, you know, but because I'm looking right here in your eyes right now, and I'm trying to figure something out. Do you think that
it was murder and it was so wrong and it was the worst thing?
I'll tell you what I think. I think it was the worst thing someone with a chip on their shoulder could possibly ever do in their lifetime, whether it was in the past life or whenever in their current life. I just think whoever did it was just a sick person. I think it was the sickest human being who ever lived. He's messed up in the head and he just has a problem. And that's the tipping point. Come on, let's go get some more drinks.
Okay, you're right. Let's go. Why can't a nose... Is that it? Okay. Why can't a nose be 12 inches? Because it'd be a foot.
make sure that they got everything ready. What do you call somebody coming out of a store that has eagles on it? That's some fly shit. Must have been something. Must have been a raccoon or a squirrel. Why did your wife...
Hi, Gerald.
Hey, what the hell are you doing here?
I mean, what the hell? Hey, what the hell are you doing here, man? How did you know where I live? Hey, get away from the boat, man. It's an expensive thing. Yeah, we just got it.
I'm sorry, man. I'm just...
What the hell are you doing? How the hell do you know where I live?
You know, I think we got a mutual friend on one of those, you know, social...
That's at the comedy place, man. What I do here is my personal business. What I do at home is absolutely all to me, okay? That's privacy, okay? You really stepped over the line here, Chad.
I'm sorry, Gerald.
Don't worry about it. What the hell are you doing out here anyway?
Yeah, I just came to support you on the new show, man. The newest upcoming event.
Yeah.
I'll be there. You know me. I'm your number one fan.
Well, by the way, when do I perform next? Like I wouldn't know?
Oh, you perform on today.
How the hell would you know that? I didn't even know that.
I knew it.
Yeah?
Yeah, I know you're going to knock him down, too.
Yeah, knock him dead, right?
Yeah, dead.
Well... Yeah, that's about that.
I think it's going to be a really funny event, you know? It's funny how things happen.
Yeah.
It's really funny. It's almost hilarious. Well, you know.
Yeah, in a comedic sense. Mm. Hey, by the way, man, I'm going to run this routine that I got for tonight. Hey, you're going to love this.
Okay.
How do astronomers organize a party? They plan it. Listen to that, check this one out.
This is the best, man. I'm telling y'all, man.
Yeah, hey, what's going on, huh? How's everybody feeling? What's going on, Star Wars House of Laughs? Everybody good? Hey, check it out. I got a story over here. You better listen to it. You might catch it right over your head. Check it out. What about, what did one plate say to the other plate? Anybody? Lunch is on me, huh? Am I right?
What's wrong? Am I right? Am I fucking wrong?
Huh?
Shit. Okay, wait a minute.
Did you hear about the guys who invented lifesavers? They made a mint!
Did you hear about, how do you make antifreeze?
Jack and Remy and chop the ice up and give me a couple bottles of champagne. Hey, boss, what are you having? What'll it be?
Give me the strongest drink you got.
All right, coming right up for you, boss. Coming right up. You, the nice looking car you drove up in here. You like any of these acts up here? They're real funny guys.
You know, everything is funny. Until it's not.
I agree. You know, you corporate America guys, you know, you guys hit it right on the nail on the head. Hey, Dad, Gerald, he's the best. you gotta love Gerald. You ever hear of this guy? He's funny.
As a matter of fact, I have. Do me a favor.
What's that?
I said do me a favor.
What I get out of this?
You get... to give Gerald my card.
All right. Is there anything else you want me to do with this thing?
Tell him there's some big, big, big opportunities ahead of
him. I'll toast to that. Toast to big opportunities, huh? Yo, go places. Fucking with corporate America. I like your boss. I like your style.
Cody, man, look at this watch, man. It's like 500 carats, man. We can buy the whole plaza. We can buy, we can set up our own bar shop. And I got a car. What? Where's the keys? Damn it, you're right. He left the watch. He didn't leave the keys.
Speaking of the keys. Oh, yeah. And you're right. I did leave my drink. I'll take that with me. But I want you to take this, Jeff. The keys that I forgot. And oh yeah, here's another pair for Cody.
Unfucking believable.
Cody! Take a look at this shit, man. The fucking keys. We're rich, let's get out of here, call the girls!
Heck
of a job. He even outdid my expectations.
Yes, sir, ladies and gentlemen. Get ready for the next act. How you guys doing?
Not as funny as Gerald.
For the next act, the next act coming up to the stage. Jeff, the chef, cook the jokes. Hornbell,
give it
up for him.
Yeah. Woo!
Carol.
Hey, yeah, yeah. Damn.
Yeah.
Hey, you know, we're here in the building. Hey, take a look at this girl in the front row. She got curlers. Hey, that makes me make some fucking trolls curl. Oh, listen. Look, she got so much toe jet. Look, if you're making a sandwich, you already got the peanut butter, what you need. What else you need to make a toe? You're gonna make a sandwich? The toe jam. Oh. She got it already there.
I love comedy.
Shit. I don't even like peanut butter. I don't even like sandwiches. I'm vegan. What the hell do you fucking call that?
What you call that here, boy?
Oh, God. Oh, hey, man, listen, hey, thanks for the compliments, man. Yeah, it was a great, great show.
Hey, Chad, man, what the hell are you doing here, man?
I'm coming out to support you, man. You had a great job.
How the fuck did you know where I was at, man?
I'm so proud of you, man. You are doing your thing, man.
Man, let me see your phone, man. You got some type of GPS, man. How do you know where I'm fucking performing every time?
Oh, come on, man. Get out of here with that. You're a funny guy. You really are a funny guy.
Well, you know what? You know what? I am. I try. You know, you can, the best that you do is try.
You're on the up. Man,
yeah,
this has been a great set, man.
Yeah, it's a lot of important people in here tonight, man.
Yeah, definitely, man.
Yeah.
So
I'm just looking at this. Got this little card. Got this little card this guy gave me.
Hey, what's that?
Well, you're not gonna trip out, are you, man? I'm just joking with you, man.
Yeah, but.
I forgot.
No. It's this guy from HBO. HBCTO. Back in the Hood. Holly Bollywood Productions. Hey, man, but it's a good opportunity, man. I've been writing jokes, man. I came from the bottom. I think it's time to take that next step, man. Take that next step to the next level. Don't you think? It'll be great. I can see it now. Gerald Cunningham. The Jokester. You know, that's what they called me down in the office.
Really?
What do you think about that, man? Don't you think it's a good opportunity? I think I'm going to do it, man. I think I'm going to do it. You know, I've got to tell my wife about it. We've been going through a whole lot, man. I hope she takes it well, man. But this is a great opportunity, don't you think, man? No, let's test it, huh? You know? What do you think?
Listen. I've been your fan, as you know, ever since your first show. And don't get me wrong, I like that you're going places, but, you know, you gotta separate different things as far as what's good for you and what's good for your audience. If you go, that won't be good for the people who got you to where you're going.
Hey, listen, look, this is Hollywood, man. This is Bali Dollarwood. This is Dollarwood. This is fucking Hollywood. This is Dollarwood, okay? The dollars are good in Dollarwood. I need to take this, man. I don't know. I'm conflicted. I'm stuck in the middle, man. I came from the bottom. I
came from the hood. I know these guys.
Oh, yeah. So what are you telling me? You're telling me that you have some good shows and all of a sudden executives want to sign you to their agency? That executive wasn't here on your first show when you got booed. I was the only one who cared. I was the only one there clapping and laughing.
What I'm saying is, Dollarwood is a great opportunity. I can reach more people. I can reach more fans. I can reach more viewers.
Your fans are here. The same place that you got discovered is the place you should be and stay at. Not where they don't know you. And all they're going to do is use you for what they can get out of you. And yeah, they'll make you money. And then, but for damn sure, they're going to make themselves money. And then when it's all said and done, they're just going to throw you away. Well, not me. I'm here to stay. Do what you want. Go to Bollywood, Hollywood, Dollywood. Put the Molly in the hood, man. I don't care. All I'm saying is that I'll be here to support you. But when Bollywood goes bad, we'll be here waiting for you, man.
I thank you, man. Yeah, you're right. Maybe this is something I should really give a whole lot of thought to, man. Maybe it's something that I should give a whole lot of thought to, man. And you know what? And I'm going to give everything that I owe to you.
What did he say to the gardener? Mow the lawn or you die.
Oh, my best work yet.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm gonna need you to give it up once again. Didn't have too much of a good show last time, but he's back. He's prepared. He got his stuff together. Come on, ladies and gentlemen, I'm gonna need you to give a warm welcome for my friend, your comedian, Jared Cunningham. Come on.
Yeah, you
right beside you, and you, because it's split the size into two U's. All right,
hey, listen, check it out. We're gonna get right into it, ladies and gentlemen.
All
right, right into it. Why does ghosts love elevators? Why do ghosts love elevators?
Why?
Anybody?
Come on, why?
Cause it lifts their spirit. What sound does a nut make when it sneezes? Cashews!
I'm right! Fucking blow your brains out, am I right?
Hey, don't faint.
Yeah, hey, listen. How many lives does a German cat have?
Nine!
Hey, listen. When did the Pink Panther say when he stepped over a dead insect? Dead ant.
Get it.
You guys are great, man. I love you guys. I'm so excited. This is the best day of my life. Just wrote these jokes, and I get to share them firsthand with my favorite comedian. Oh, God, I'm so nervous. Gerald! Come on, Gerald, open the door.
Not now, Chad. I don't have time.
No, you don't understand, Gerald. I got this script. I just came up with it, man.
Not
you know you're
now.
My number
I don't
one
have
influence.
The time.
Come on, man. Where are you going?
I'm going to Hollywood. Where the hell do you fucking think I'm going?
Hollywood? What are you talking about?
I got a big deal. I gotta get it done.
Wait a minute, Gerald.
Just tell it to the guy at the bar. He listens to it all the time.
Gerald, come on, man. I got the script.
I gotta go. Just come get the hell out of here.
Gerald,
right? Gerald. Good luck to your life, all right, Chad? Thanks.
Thank you.
finished.
Another great take, Gerald. Woo! Yeah!
Thanks. Thanks. Somebody give me a drink.
Come on, take a cold shower. We'll wrap this up in the morning.
The event going on the next 3 weeks here is really unbelievable. We're about to explain why.
All right, everybody, show some love. You know how we do it in here. Show all your energy. Give all your energy to our next comedian. Come on the stage. This is his first time. He's a virgin to this. And his name is Just Chad. All right, Just Chad. Give it up for him. Woo! Yeah, boy. What you got for me, boy?
Yeah. But you ever hear the joke about the comedian? The
fuck is this guy talking about?
The comedian, see, he never did a show before. He never did a set. Not like those two were mutually exclusive, but long story short, and I know it's past that, we're past that. But he got booed off stage.
Boo!
I'm not finished yet. He got booed off stage. But see, there was one guy in the crowd who laughed.
Give me a drink, man.
He wasn't laughing because he got booed off stage. He was actually supporting him. He was actually trying to respect his craft.
Boo!
But see, the funny thing, though it's no laughing matter, is that sometimes people get booed off stage.
Boo! Get the fuck out of here. Get the fuck out of here. Boo.
I thought you might boo me.
Boo. Get him out of here.
So my gift to you.
Boo.
Just for shits and giggles.
Hey, what the fuck is this?
Nobody's making it out of here alive.
What the fuck is going on?
The joke's on you, Gerald.
Alright, listen, no, keep it on. The camera's still rolling. This is the end of
No Laughing Matter.
And it's not a laughing matter. I want to thank my man, Scott.
Man,
yes, sir.
Happy to do it, man.
We finally did it, man. And you guys can watch it right here. It's going up on the YouTube channel. Check it out. Bloopers and all. Laugh to your heart is content. Laugh to your stomach burns.
Get the laughing gas, man.
In the laughing chamber. The laughing gas in the laughing chamber. It's all over with. Thanks for watching. Ladies and gentlemen, the joke's on you.